the 2020 food trend no one predicted. It is now almost laughable, reading back the list of the foods we would all be excited by in 2020. However, I can guarantee none of them listed what I consider to be 2020's major food trend, the quarantine meal, eaten by those of us lucky enough to spend 2 weeks trapped in a hotel room. They were left outside our locked doors 3 times a day by a person we never saw. Across the world, people flew into quarantine facilities and were treated to mass catering, which provided some truly weird and wonderful combinations, some of it good, some of it edible, and some of it best forgotten at speed. It was a positive spin on airplane food, Henry Parham says of the regimen of blueberry muffins, eggs, and quiche which got left outside his room in Melbourne, Australia, after his return for the US earlier this year. Lukewarm school dinners was the analogy I would have chosen for my own experience of quarantine food here in Singapore. However, where we were agreed was that the food arriving at the door at least broke up the monotony of 15 days within the same walls. I never knew what we were getting, Henry recalls. I also never knew quite what was going to turn up, and my haphazard selections ended up producing some interesting and unexpected combinations, including a quinoa wrap and mashed potatoes, slabs of cold egg and drowned beans and, on one particularly memorable occasion, a tentacle and noodle combo with a smell so strong it was immediately ejected from the room. She still cries, months on, while noodles received by a fellow Singaporean quarantiner were described as looking like worms. A colleague later analyzed a picture of said noodles and declared they were actually known locally as rat's tail noodles. However, with 3 different cuisines to choose from in Singapore for each meal, we at least couldn't complain about having to eat the same thing repeatedly. The same cannot be said for Josie Fudge, a copyright gibbon, who spoke to the BBC while she was just over a week into quarantining in Bergen, Norway. "It's a lot of pasta," she says, exasperated. Indeed, getting food to the thousands in quarantine, arriving from all over the world, with different tastes and preferences, is not an easy job. But it is frustrating when you know there is such good food available just out of reach. Singapore, for example, is known for its amazing dishes, many of which I have since gulped down. But then it turns out it didn't need to be this way. Meet Sam Lowe, the award-winning New Zealand barista who dedicated his time to transforming the everyday into something, well, spectacular. "It kind of went weirdly crazy and viral," he says a few weeks after New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern shared his Instagram pictures of his transformed quarantine meals. Sam had arrived back from Australia forewarned, armed with scissors and cooking utensils after watching friends documenting their experiences. And so, he set about turning his meals into small works of art, a far better pastime than Henry discovered, which revolved around reading the packaging of all of his food. Sam was not inhaling his food in 10 seconds flat. There was, however, a secret: the food which looked so good on camera was often not the most interesting to actually eat. "I think they did it on purpose to cater for every person," Sam says. "I brought 2 of the world's best-selling condiments with me," he says, proudly, before summing up why he thinks his pictures were so popular. "Even so, I think we are all hoping quarantine meals will be one trend which remains in 2020.